he gave George Lucas the idea of creating Indiana Jones. And if you see Gene Savoy's picture, he looks like Indiana Jones, and he traveled in the Americas seeking the ancient wisdom, seeking the most powerful spiritual wisdom, and seeking these hidden cultures, these disappeared cultures. He found these Incans who were living high in the mountains in the Amazon in Peru, and he was taught sun gazing from them. And then he returned and shared that with the world. And his message is very much about the Christ consciousness, which he believed and experienced was descending more fully upon this earth. And it's interesting. It's kind of a descension, ascension. You know, we create within and it comes from without. They both go hand in hand. It's like the central sun within the universe is sending us more Christed energy, more divine light, as well as our central sun within our heart is manifesting outward more Christ consciousness, divine light. So it's really amazing how nearly every culture has these spiritual practices that revolve around the sun. And as a final note, there are human beings on this earth who have learned to live directly off of sunlight. It begins by training yourself to absorb more prana, removing any types of behaviors, any types of foods that are reducing our prana, or the amount of prana or energy we can store in our body, until we eventually get the place of being light beings embodied, where we live from the light of the sun or from the light of God. And that's how the Christ, that's how Jesus Christ lived. That's how many yogis live today. And it's quite possible that's how many Incans live as well, the ones who are living outside of, you know, the mainstream Peruvian society.
Wow, yeah. That's really something else. Something that I just like to add.
Mm-hmm.
When you were talking about charging the water, something that I do is I have a little quartz crystal that's like really thin. It's a Lemurian sea quartz. And I'll put that in my water before I drink any bottled water at all. And I put it in the water. And this is something that I learned from Montauk Chia. I saw Montauk Chia do this, mm-hmm. The famous Taoist energy healer, or energy guru, I should say, Taoist guru. If you hold the bottle of water to your heart center, and especially with the quartz center, the quartz crystal, it's really going to collect a lot of that prana. And what you do is you just hold it there for a little bit, and you charge it with your intention, whatever you'd like it to be, you know, happiness, just anything, a positive intention, as Dr. Masaru Emoto has proven, will alter the actual chemical, maybe not chemical, but the information that's creating those little molecules of water will be altered just from your intention, which is really quite incredible. When you make this by holding it to your chest and you take some sips of it afterwards, you can notice how that it seeps into your energy body. You'll start to feel it creeping down your legs and, you know, through the rest of your centers. And it's an easy way to charge your energy up or to give it to someone else who's sick or to somebody who you'd like to offer it to. But either way, working like that with our water, and I've never heard that about charging it with the sun, but that's a great idea. I've always learned to not leave your water out in the sun, but put it out in the sun and then stick it in the freezer for a little bit.
Yeah, it's actually interesting. I'm going to India in a few days, and in India there's a big problem with pure water. It's difficult to find pure drinking water, and I came across some research that was very interesting, and it's actually the United Nations has an organization that deals with health. I forget the name of it or the initials for it. However, this United Nations organization found that one of the most effective ways to purify water is to leave your water outside in the sunlight. Because the UV light from the sun purifies your water and will kill bacteria. It'll kill viruses. It'll kill any organisms that are toxic or harmful. So it's amazing. Yeah, it's amazing. Even the United Nations recognizes this. Now, what's important with that is that your bottle does not block UV light. Most glass bottles, just like window pane glass, does block UV light. So you want to use a light or a glass such as Pyrex. There's a few other types of glass that do allow UV light through it. In addition, United Nations does say you can use PET plastic. It's a certain type of plastic bottle because it does allow UV light through it. But one thing that's important to remember is that plastic has other toxic substances in it. So plastic, when put in sunlight or when exposed to heat, will leach chemicals into your drinking water. So that's been shown to be hazardous. So what's most important is to find a high-quality glass that does allow UV light to pass through it. But it's interesting that the sun does have so much of what we need. It has so much energy and all this great healing. And what I've found, since I started the Sunlightenment website, I've done a lot of research and friends have shared with me a lot of great science about the sun. And what I've learned is that skin cancer is not caused by the sun, and that really the sun does every amazing thing for our body, for our mental health. Depression can be cleansed by getting adequate sunlight. Your skin can actually become more resilient to disease, to cancer, by exposing it to the sun. That it's actually improper oils and fats that we ingest in our body that cause skin cancer. Because these fats and these oils are not able to be broken down by the body, so they're stored in our fat. They're stored and they block our pores. Antiperspirants that have heavy metals in them, they block our pores. They don't let our body detox through sweating. So it's really not the sun that's hazardous. It's these unnatural forms of living that we've done that are causing all of our forms of disease. But as is common in the modern day marketplace, the media places blame outside of human behavior. Humans have a bizarre tendency right now of not taking responsibility for their creations. Whether it is the thoughts in your mind, whether it is the words that you speak, whether it's the emotions that you express, human beings don't take responsibility for what they're doing. And it also is evident in the media. We create these toxic things, we cut down the rainforest, we burn things, we throw garbage into the rivers and into the oceans, and yet the world's deteriorating around us and we blame it on other things. We point the finger somewhere else besides ourselves, and it's the same with our healthcare. We blame everything around us for causing us harm when really it's our own behavior that causes our own cancers. It's our own behavior that causes disease. I came across an interesting bit of information from a friend of mine. He read, and I'm not sure the source, but he read that when the first explorers came to America, they found Native Americans, they found Native Indians in America who were hundreds of years old. They were extremely old and they were in perfect health. And as you recall, when white man came to America, there was not disease in America. There was not illness. There was not viruses. And so white man gave all their viruses to these Native Americans because the Native Americans never needed to develop immunity because they lived in a pristine world. They lived in a world that was in harmony with nature. So we have Native Indians.